I am standing on the southeast corner of 9th and G in front of what used to be the Pacific Telephone and Telegraph Garage Company, built back all the way in 1932 with addition around 1946. And then this garage and this structure was just deemed historical within the last 1 to 2 years because of its history. Now it is the Farkas Store Fixtures. I've lived here 12 years. I walk by this structure all the time, not to go to CrossFit, yes, to go to Corner Chicken, but I don't know what it is. So I peek my head in, I don't know what they do, but maybe they build or store, you know, those glass encasements that you see in stores. So yes, the Farkas Fixture Store on the corner of 9th and G, where we don't know what they're doing, but what's really, really, really exciting is this 36,000 square foot structure is gonna turn into an urban Target. You heard me correctly, an urban Target with a grocery store and alcohol. And they actually got a variance in the alcohol sales from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. So we could start drinking earlier and maybe finish up a little later. But in all seriousness, this is something we really need. Any reason for me or anyone that lives in downtown not to have to go to Mission Valley is a huge win for the city. I say it so many times, I feel like downtown San Diego is more for visitors than the residents that live here. So with this urban Target, so cool. It's so needed in East Village, and it's just a really great thing to have in the neighborhood. What's kind of cool too is it's not just gonna be an urban Target. There's gonna be 5 stories of parking built above, and then a 22-story residential tower with 241 residences built above this urban Target, which is awesome because again, we need more denser projects. We need more Targets downtown because it will up the count from 0 to 1 for my English speaking friends. They haven't announced if it's gonna be for rent or for sale. If you want my opinion, it sounds like they're going for the for rent way, which is kind of a bummer, but still, you know what they say in San Diego, we need more doors, we gotta put them somewhere. So the amenities in 9G, and again 9G because we're on 9th and G, very clever on the name, more clever on the amenities that are gonna be going into this building. So what's really cool is they're gonna have a rooftop deck along with a rooftop pool and jacuzzi, which aren't very common in East Village. I only know maybe of 1 or 2 of them, if that. There's gonna be a wine room, a game room, plenty of outdoor space with fire pits and lounges, a fitness center, a dog park, and an outdoor theater, which is kind of cool, especially, you know, with everything going on, you have to stay at home. But now I'm going tangents because this is gonna be opened in 2 to 3 years and hopefully we're gonna be allowed to leave by then. This seems really cool, seems really modern looking with a little bit of the Art Deco, because again, this building is historic. They can't do too many changes to it. I'm sure it'll have Target written on it. I'm sure we'll have its Target a bullseye, and I'm sure this structure will be red, hopefully with this mural still attached to it. But it is an Art Deco piece, and it is historic because this structure is almost 100 years old, built in 1932, with the addition in 1946. We're very excited. This project, I should have probably said in the beginning, is called 9G because duh, we're on the corner of 9th and G. So 9G, the developer is Sistera, which is pretty local. If you remember Sistera, if it sounds familiar, they did the Sempra Energy building in East Village, and they're also a part of the Ritz-Carlton project that is finally gonna be breaking ground in a couple months. If you've seen that video, go back to it. If you need a refresh on what's gonna be happening there, because it is breaking ground, super, super cool. This project, in my opinion, probably should have broken ground because on the website it says a completion year or date of 2023. I don't know much about much, but I do believe it takes longer than 2 years, 2.5 years to construct a 22-story tower and take care of a historic structure from the 1930s. I may be wrong. I hope I'm wrong. Hey, if it opens up in 2022, I'm in for it. But it does say 2023. Again, 36,000 square foot Target, grocery store, liquor store, 5 stories of parking, 243 parking spaces, 22 stories of residences, 241 of those. Rooftop pool, rooftop jacuzzi, rooftop deck, outdoor spaces with fire pits and lounges, a wine room, a game room, and a fitness center, all encompassed in here. We don't know if it's for rent, we don't know if it's for sale, but it's gonna be for something, that's for sure. Sestera paid a couple million dollars to get out of the low income housing requirements that San Diego does require. But of course, money takes care of anything and everything. So they did pay off that. It was a couple million. And now it's just going to be market rate for market rate for sale or market rate for rent. For sale, hopefully, probably for rent. There's the roundup. I am standing on the corner of 9th and G in front of Future 9G. My name is David Spiewak, a your go-to guy for all things San Diego, including Targets, residential buildings, and of course, real estate. I mean, can it get any louder around here? Like, why don't we just add a plane and then see how well this microphone works with this urban living? I mean, seriously, right? Wow,